Now let's see about multi-threading models in operating system. Mainly there are three types of multi-threading models are available. First one, many to one model. Second one, one to one model. Third one, many to many model. Let's see about many to one model. Here, many number of user threads are mapped to a single kernel thread. So that means for a process, only one kernel thread will be created. And all the user threads are mapped to this kernel thread. Okay, so here we have three user threads, and the three user threads are mapped to this kernel thread. The major disadvantage of this approach is here we have only one kernel thread. So if we have a multiprocessor architecture, then it is not possible to use here. Multiprocessor architecture means instead of single processor, we can have multiple processors, but here at a time only one thread can access the kernel, and here we don't have multiple kernels, so it is not possible to use multiprocessors in order to achieve the parallelism. So parallelism is not achieved by this approach. Why? Because we have only one processor, we have only one kernel. So in order to overcome this limitation, we are using the second approach, that is one-to-one model. So one-to-one model solves the limitation of many-to-one model. The limitation of many-to-one model is it doesn't implement multiprocessor architecture. So it doesn't implement parallelism, concurrency. Whereas coming to the one-to-one model, here each user thread is mapped to a separate kernel thread. So this is thread 1. So for this thread 1 is mapped to this kernel thread. So this is thread 2. So this thread 2 is mapped to this kernel thread. So this is thread 3. So this thread 3 is mapped to this kernel thread. So if one thread is blocked, then there is no problem. Why? Because the remaining threads can access those corresponding kernel threads. So the remaining user threads can be executed by the CPU. The major problem with this approach is the number of kernel threads which we want to create. If we create more number of threads, then it is burden on the computer. Okay, so the performance of the computer will be degrades, will be reduces. Let us assume that in order to execute a process, we have created 20 threads. So for 20 threads, we need to create, for 20 user threads, we need to create what? 20 kernel threads by the operating system. We know that operating system creates kernel threads, whereas this user threads are created by our process, our application. Okay, so 20 kernel threads are created by the operating system. So it is very, very burden on the computer. So the performance of the computer will be reduces. In order to solve these limitations, we can use this many to many model. Many to many model solves the limitation of many to one model as well as one to one model. Okay, here the name itself specifies the meaning. Many number of user threads are mapped to equal or less number of kernel threads. That means if there are 10 user threads, then the number of kernel threads are either 10 or less than 10. Okay, so here there are multiple user threads are there. So for multiple user threads, these threads are mapped to corresponding kernel threads. Okay, so if one thread is blocked, then there is no problem. Here for this thread, we will be having three kernel threads. So if one thread is blocked, then the remaining kernels will access by the, then the remaining kernel threads will access the corresponding user threads. So the remaining user threads are to be executed by the CPU. So likewise here, what is the problem here? What is the problem with one-to-one model? Operating system has to create more number of threads. Here, the number of kernel threads are less when compared with the number of user threads. So here, there is no problem here. There is no need to create many number of threads by the operating system. So we can say that out of all these approaches, many-to-many model is the best approach. And nowadays, all the operating systems are using many-to-many model. Many-to-many model, okay? So here, each user thread is mapped to what? Multiple kernel threads. So many number of user threads are mapped to many number of kernel threads. So thread 1 is mapped to 3 kernel threads. Thread 2 is mapped to 3 kernel threads. Thread 3 is mapped to 3 kernel threads, like that. So this is about multi-threading models in operating system.